Thank you. Not that time, well. Good morning.
You're not monkey, sir?
No.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Do you mind waiting a bit so that
no problem.
The gentleman takes your temperature?
Okay.
In the meantime, there's the sanitizer.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. Let's.
You can start through here, sir.
Ah. Thank you. Grazie, thank you.
For more information, the 120-year-old struggle between Rome and Carthage was the bloodiest war in ancient history. Both sides realized that this was a fight to the death. Malta belonged to the Carthaginians. Tradition places the birth of their famous general Hannibal at Tel Barca on Gozo. Ironically, the sea-based Carthaginians learned to fight on land. The land-based Romans countered with their very first navy. Tiberius Sempronius Romulus claimed Malta for Rome in 218 before Christ. During the Second Punic War, Malta was the vital north-south stepping stone to Africa for the Romans. In 535, Malta became an outpost of the Byzantine Empire, attacked by Julian Flavius and the Seleucids. It was a place of exile for people out of favor in Constantinople. In the mid-7th century, Arabs swept across North Africa. Malta was back into the front line between two competing civilizations. By 870, Malta conformed to the Arabs, captured by Caliph al-Qadi. But nomadic warriors of another kind were filtering southwards. Roman mercenaries began offering their services to various Italian principalities. A group led by Count Roger wrestled Sicily and Malta back from the Arabs in 1091 AD. Malta was now Christianity's southmost bulwark against Islam. In 1266, Malta became a dominion of Angevins from France under Charles of Anjou. They were overthrown by the Angevins from Spain in 1283 by Roger of Lorient. For both these powers, Malta represented the furthest extension of their empires. The Order of St. John was a religious and military order dating back to the Crusades. In 1522, the Ottoman sultan Suleiman. Fort Saint Angelo sits at a steep, rocky outcrop in the heart of the Grand Harbour. The community dominates the use of the harbour and carries creek, sheltered in the water ships and the river opens up as the only site of the first time in the harbour to visit Fort St. Angelo. It is like you have another entry as the one we can get to the top of the harbour in the water system. It is also in the next villages, it was known as Castrum Maris, the house of the sea, also in the many year-long coast villages. In here, the capital was situated on a hill in the middle of the Arab Empire, as the home of the castellan, which after the lands and castles. Castrum Maris was a simple farm operation, operated almost as same as the estate. was rumored that Fort Saint Angelo was to be demolished. This caused an uproar in the Council of Government. They renamed the fort HMS Egmont in 1912. This caused further resentment. So in 1933, the Navy bowed to Maltese greetings. They renamed the fort HMS Saint Angelo. From 1940 to 1943, was the subject of a second Great Siege. Once again, the outcome of the terrible consequences. Its shrapnel scarred ramparts loomed defiantly above the smoke of burning ships and the dust of bomb buildings. Once again, the fort became a symbol of Malta triumphant against the odds. The fort's calming presence served to remind the islanders and the outsiders of Malta's past cities. The Second World War reinforced Fort Saint Angelo's prestige as a symbol of
After this. Yeah.